It is March 14th, 2021. I am quarantined in the northern woods of Wisconsin, and a year ago today, I was on my way back from Orlando with a bus full of Southwest guitar students. Both are great days. A lot has transpired in the last 365 days. Today, I will release our concert that was, gosh, due a long, long time ago, from last spring. I'm so glad I didn't know then what I know now about spending a year alone, but I have learned a lot about myself, about my students, about what's important and where my values are, where my priorities lie, and the ability to discard what is not important, to choose what I want to bring back and what I don't. So as I spend my final days up here as I prepare to return to in-person learning, I just thought it was the right day to share with you all that has transpired in the last year. Enjoy Strings of Strength. And welcome to Strings of Strength. This is the 2020 guitar concert, if we call it that, collage collection of pictures and memories and things that celebrate our year of being musicians together. I have been on the stage hundreds and hundreds of times with thousands and thousands of children, and I can honestly say this is the very first time I have introduced a performance from the comfort of my office. So, without further ado, we will recognize seniors tonight. We have some really cool awards to give out. Actually, we have a beginning award, a founding award tonight that will become the highlight of the guitar department. We have so many things to celebrate. It was a huge year for the guitar department, even though our year ended, really, performing-wise, out there on March. We have hit the national spotlight. People have been emailing me, curious about how we do what we do. And together, I am not the only educator, but all of your wonderful students, children, and growing young adults. We are all educators together. So as I sit here, and here we are, Strings of Strength.
We got the beat. The amp challenge.
The amp challenge. Share with your friends. She's like, I have it.
Oh god. She can do this. She can do this.
Do the roar.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
Now just about 7 for you, singing by Hello, by B-E-Y-O-N-C-E.
Thank you. I'm doing this. My mom's bringing home cake and pizza. Sorry, I was reading a text message. Okay.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Abigail Johnson. This is a song I wrote for my band. It's called The Truth.
Out, I'm stuck in my own head. Feels like you're the judge and I'm being sentenced. The problem is I'm the villain for something I never did. I'm under fire, pressured to keep the emotions back in my mind. And coming, there's a guy inside, pushing everything that's been kept inside. I'm locked in a cell. I'm so sick of being the bad guy. Someone come stop me before I start to lose my mind. Before I start to lose my mind. came along, since you came along. Your touch is sunlight through the trees, your kisses are the ocean breeze. Everything's alright when you're with me. Feel so right. So I pour my heart into your hands. It's like you really understand. You love the way I am. And I, oh, my favorite thing. Oh, the happiness you bring. Well, it feels like I've opened my eyes again. And the colors are gone. You came along. It's a better place since you came along.
If you have been to a guitar concert in the last 4 years, you undoubtedly know this face. It is the epitome of joy. This guy, Lucas Whitman, is happy 24/7. It is no doubt that he is my choice this year for the Spirit Award. Over the last 4 years, you have watched Lucas at the keyboard, at the microphone, at the guitar. All in all, Lucas is the heartbeat to our three strings band. And that face shows us how easily that can be true. In addition to being an amazing musician and wonderful spirit, Lucas has two things he really enjoys in life. One is his love of bags. And while in Disney World, he found this glitter bag that you see in the photo. And it is now happily in his room. The other thing that you may or may not know about Lucas is he loves coded handshakes. So here he is in this video teaching one of the Disney characters his handshake. And his big brother, Nick, is with him enjoying that moment. We thought we'd share.
Wow.
Nice. All right.
Welcome. We are here with two of the guitar department's top seniors. It's been an absolute joy to share 4 years with them. Louis Tears and Nico Basic. These two gentlemen have just given their all in our guitar department and seen it grow, helped nurture it, and been a big part of why it is as strong as it is now, because of their dedication, their leadership, their talent, their maturity, their strengths, all of those things. So truly, usually the director's choice person stands out really strongly, and then the student choice stands out really strongly. This year, I really have to say, the students and I agree completely, and Nico will formally get the Director's Choice Award, Louis will formally get the Student Choice Award, and they could be flip-flopped. They're just such dynamite guys, and we all think that, the students and I do as well. So together, you two have fostered a friendship. You've performed together in lots of ways. In fact, we're going to end this with a duet on a park bench. That's so cool. Your energy together, your spirit, your lightheartedness, your leadership, you're willing to just help out anybody for musical reasons or for any kind of situation they need. Touring with you has been an absolute joy and lots of memories to be made. And just really overall the positive energy that you bring each and every day over the last few years. We're gonna miss you a lot, I won't lie. But we're also super excited about the pathway that you have forged for yourself forward. So let's go ahead and have you guys look at the awards. I just do this cool little ditty where I turn my music stand around. We're in my office here, so we'll see if we can get it to get into view here nicely. So those are, let's see. La la la. Kind of tricky. There we go. Light's funky, I think. See it okay, guys?
Yeah, it looks awesome.
Yeah, cool. All right. So let's take just a second. And if you want to share a couple moments that stand out to you in the guitar department, now would be your time.
I think tour just in general has been definitely the highlight of every year of my time at guitar in the guitar program. And definitely I think the New Orleans tour specifically was when Louis and I bonded and really formed that friendship. So
that was your sophomore? Was that your sophomore year?
Yeah, definitely a memory that stands out to me.
Cool.
Yeah, definitely, like, every single tour I've been on has been, like, every tour has been just amazing. This last one has been one of my favorite experiences of, like, my entire life. It was just so much fun, just really crazy, and, yeah, it was pretty awesome to end, like, my school year like that, basically.
Yeah, we really did end the school year with the tour. Yeah. We got back Saturday night, and school was called off Sunday night, so, I don't think any of us were seeing that. And all our gear is still sitting on the floor.
Oh, my God.
Because we just walked out. So, gentlemen, I'm so excited to present you with awards. And I really look forward to your returning. You know, you got to paint your bricks on the wall yet. That's still going to be a thing when it's safe to return. I know that Prism Rose was talking about it. They have their bricks all picked out. So hopefully you do, too. Right. And when it is safe, we will come together again in the room and put your forever signature on it.
Awesome. I can't wait. That's going to be awesome.
All right. Hey, guys, thanks so much. And for those of you listening, we will segue right into a duet these gentlemen are playing. You want to say anything about the duet before we hear it?
It's called Is There Anybody Out There by Pink Floyd. And it's just a nice instrumental piece that Louis and I modified a little bit.
Cool. Louis, you want to say anything about it?
It sounds nice.
All right. Thanks, guys, and congrats. We'll see you when it's safe. All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
And welcome. I am here with three seniors that have been absolutely outstanding for the last 4 years in our guitar department. They have grown as musicians, as young, amazing women, and as leaders in our community. And I want to just kind of take some time and stop a moment and thank them publicly, and really just put into place in time a way to recognize all they have done for the Southwest High School Guitar Department. There was this word I came across this year in a bigger project with my three strings, and I ran into the word kismet. Kismet has a foundation in the Arabic language, and in short, it means your destiny. So you are destined to be here, or you are destined for that experience. And based on that word, I like words. I like what they mean. I like the way they sound. I like the word kismet, and just the oral feeling it gives me to hear it. And without belaboring that, I really want to acknowledge our three recipients of the Kismet Award: Kayla Wigg, up in our top left; Abby Johnson, down in our bottom left; and Isabel Lowe, right below me here. Isabel, wave, so we know who you are. And this is the formal presentation of the Kismet Award. The Kismet Award, it's new this year, and it is now our highest award that's being given by the Southwest High School Department. It is reserved for the student that has discovered a life-altering experience or given a life-altering experience during their time in the guitar education program at Southwest High School. And to commemorate the initiation of this award and to celebrate its fullest meaning, the award will be given in future years bearing these three ladies' names as the initial recipients. Their dedication to music, their personal integrity, individuality, maturity, friendship, their artistic expression, and so many things beyond that only getting to know them would ever let you know, has strengthened and led our entire guitar community beyond measure. Collectively, they have encouraged their future guitarists to reach the level of excellence they have achieved, and they are only beginning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so excited to see where they are headed. Thank you for your dedication, sharing yourselves with others, and your coming together was kismet. So these are the awards we had made up. There will be a plaque that hangs in our guitar room that says kismet, explains what kismet is, and your names appear in order with 2020 and forever, as long as we have a guitar department at Southwest High School, which I hope is forever, your three names go on there. And I will explain when the awards are given from here on out who you three ladies are and the contributions that you made, and really just the powerful teaching you have given us. So here are plaques, though, because I have to say, I'm here in my studio, and it's not a Kismet Award, but it's a John Philip Sousa Award, because I was a trumpet player, and I got it in my senior year in high school, and it has been with me always. So of all the honors and all the plaques and all the cool things that have happened through the years, that's really an award that I have really found to be a big deal in my life. So I am hoping this award is that for you. And here are those awards. I'll spin you around. We have this really high quality setup on a music stand. And then I got to come around.
Sure. Oh my gosh.
Whoa. They look so official.
Right. So each of you get to take that with you and have that forever. So
I love it. I can see it. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. So it says on each of them, it's kismet. When you encounter something or someone by chance and it seems meant to be, then it could be kismet, your destiny. So, I don't know. You each get a few minutes to, or a few seconds. A little response.
Yeah, minutes.
Well, I just want to thank you because, that award's really meaningful. And I started in the guitar program freshman year, not really knowing where it would go. But guitar class ended up being my favorite class every single year. And now I'm pursuing a career in music and doing something that I love. And it wouldn't have happened without you. It all happened in your class. So thank you.
Cool. Thank you, Abby.
Yeah, I mean, I would also like to thank you for just creating a program that will allow us to explore and expand and change. Because I mean, obviously, freshman year guitar program wasn't the same. But you said, you know what? I like your ideas. Let's see what we can do with them. And I really appreciate that, as well. And I'll also be like studying for music education. So I hope that one day I can have like a guitar program similar where like I let like kind of kids decide like what they want to learn and how they should learn it. So it'd be cool.
Cool. Sooner or later, I might get to retire. So maybe it'll be done and ready to put it on.
That'd be interesting. Maybe I'll be a student teacher.
That'd be cool.
I also want to thank you, Miss LeMay, for everything. My like passion for music began at Southwest, and I didn't have any like knowledge of music before, so it's crazy for me to like try and pursue music. And you know, I wouldn't know what I would be doing right now without music. And I also just want to thank you for teaching me everything you could, and also believing in my abilities to do things I wanted to do, even though I like felt like sometimes I wasn't enough, and like, you know, just giving me opportunities to like show what I'm capable of. Like, so thankful for everything. And you know, time flown by so fast, like I can't believe like I'm already a senior. So like, thank you for all the memories and like for the recognition, of course, and everything. Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, ladies, it's just been wonderful. And for our audience watching, if you've never had the chance, I'll give you one more opportunity. This happens to be my favorite. It's hard to choose. These are three amazingly talented young women that are prolific songwriters, all of them. But one that has stood the test of time, they already know what I'm going to do. Isabel wrote a song when she was a freshman in high school, and it's just kind of their signature tune. So this is a song written by Isabel, harmonized with all three of them. All right, so follow with me, and we will listen to Darling.
Thank you. don't you cry, keep you close to me tonight.
Thank you, everybody, for coming along and watching Strings of Strength, our final concert of the 2020 school year. And we look forward to being together again when it is safe and we can be in person, and I'll go back on stage and I can actually see all the beautiful faces and interact with all the kids. We are anxious to be together. Until that time, take care, be safe, be well, make good choices, and we'll see you next year.